Hi everybody, it is October 1st, 4th, why did I say 1st? October 4th. We had our announcement today, didn't really say anything, it's like a 3-stage getting out of level 3, anyways we're staying in level 3. The Prime Minister acted like we haven't already had our doors open for our early childhood, but I guess some centers wouldn't have, because it was kind of only for people who were essential workers, as per, but nothing was, you know, we were allowed to have parents who were just struggling or whatever. But some centers hadn't opened because keeping to the bubble of 10 was too hard. Anyways, she's acted like it was closed and we're all of a sudden opening. Because the weird thing is the bubbles are still there. So it is just bubbles of 10. Have a meeting tomorrow to find out whether or not I'm actually working this week. I would only actually work Wednesday because I have Thursday, Friday off. So just waiting to see. They talked about transitioning teachers out. What I think is going to happen, because the wage subsidy is carrying on, but this has actually been going on for 7 weeks. So 7 weeks they've been paying us. About 3 of those weeks at 80%, 4 of those weeks at 100%. So, and there's no end in sight. So we have no idea when we're going to go down and be able to have more kids come in. We've got 5 rooms, which means we can have a max of 10 children in each room. And it means that we can have a max of 15 teachers probably on site. So it'd be 50 children and 3. So I went and I worked on Thursday and Friday, and it was just pretty much stay in your room, eat in your room. The cook was the only one in the kitchen really, and he would just leave. I think he made everything next door at that kitchen, and then he just left it on either a trolley outside your room for you to grab, or he left it up for us on the upstairs table, and we would just grab it when it was our morning tea, afternoon tea, and lunch, and it was all prepared. So we didn't have too much running in with him. If we ever went out to collect that food, we had to wear a mask. If we went to the toilet, we had to wear a mask. Didn't have to wear a mask outside, as long as we were in, like, the four walls of our center, pretty much. But yeah, like, try to keep the windows open as much as possible, to let, like, the air stream in. Basically, that's what work is looking right now and will continue to look like for who knows how long. That does mean there'll be a lot of kids still at home. We are sent out about 120 kids. So yeah, not sure when we're going to open up to that. So we can have personally in our room between 3 and 5 more kids, I think, depending on the days. So I'm not sure how that's going to work. And like I said, they're trying to get some teachers who have been at home, like myself, into the center. Now, I think possibly because I wonder if we're going to go down to that wage subsidy. So they want to try to get people being able to get 100%. And you can only get 100% if you're working or if you take annual leave. So I'm not exactly sure. So don't quote me on that. I will have to let you guys know. So this is a little card that I have. I wanted to share with you. There's been lots of talk of, like, vaccination card. I kind of see this, like, in Canada. Most of you guys are from Canada, so you know. We've got that little yellow booklet, which I do have somewhere here in the house. I've just seen it recently with, like, mumps and rubella and stuff written on it. Here they do things slightly differently. You've got, like, a wellness book or something. But, yeah, so far this is our card. And we haven't had to use these for anything, but we're about to start having to use them, I'm pretty sure, to go into, like, bars and stuff whenever they open. And Air New Zealand, so the airline has just come up with, unless you are fully vaccinated, you won't be able to. So I'm not sure whether or not we're going to get something different to this, but we laminated it just in case this is all we're going to get. So yeah. So I wanted to show that to you guys tonight. Gonna do something a little bit different as I'm prepping for this video. Gonna put this in my room. One sec. Okay, so no one's in the house and it's just me. I thought it might be nice to take you through, like, so we take turns cooking. I cook majority of times just once a week. Sometimes I cook twice a week. I'm hopefully going to be away Thursday, Friday. I'll talk to you guys about that in a minute, or hopefully from Wednesday. I'm supposed to be from tomorrow, but things have changed. I'll tell you about it in a minute. But yeah, so we get HelloFresh. I don't know if any of you guys do HelloFresh. None of you guys have said. So variety of meals. Last night we had a chicken something, chicken like seeded and breaded on top of spinach, pumpkin, and beetroot. It was really yum. With a mayo dressing, so it was really good. Tonight I'm gonna make enchiladas because majority of you guys know that I'm crazy about tacos or enchiladas. My flatmate was actually saying she thinks in another life I was like a Mexican or something because I'm crazy about like lasagna and pizza. A Mexican or Italian, lasagna, pizza, tacos, enchiladas, I love them. So I'm gonna make these, so I'll take you through the recipe in a minute. There's teriyaki glazed pork and sesame fries is one of the meals. Vietnamese style pork and peanuts. I'm actually glad I'm not home for that one. Chicken and creamy peppercorn sauce. Actually, I thought that was the one we were gonna have last night. I thought the peppercorn sauce might be a little bit tricky for me to make. But yeah, we didn't have that. We had something different. Anyway, so it comes with 5. We also ordered the fruit this time, but we don't really like it. We're not gonna order the fruit package again. We got like 15 or 16 things of fruit for $16. It was just what's in season. So we got a pineapple. It looks like we got 4 or 5 oranges, about 3 or 4 apples, and then 3 or 4 pears. So anyways, so the cool thing about HelloFresh is that they've got the list on the back for what you do every time. I'm not pickling the onions because nobody in this house likes pickled onions, so I'm just going to do fry up the onions to make the cucumber and onion salad. Well, not sure if it's salad or whatever. So yeah, it's really easy. 3, it's for the red. So it's got the red on here. And what we've actually done is we've actually put the meat in here as well. And just have it in the fridge. Because then it's all together and we make sure that we haven't screwed up anything. So it's actually got everything. The meat. The onion. The tortilla shells. Oh, is that radish? Ew, I hate radish. It's too spicy for me, but I'll figure it out. Radish. Enchilada sauce. A couple carrots. What's this? Greek style yogurt. Shredded cheddar cheese. Tex-Mex special blend and a cucumber. So it comes with everything that you need. And if you need, there's another radish. And if you need anything from your pantry, it'll tell you down at the bottom, pantry items, olive oil, vinegar, and sugar. And it tells you how much of each thing you need on here. We cook for 4, even though there's only 3 of us, and then we have one for lunch. Normally for one of us. So it's really easy. I'm gonna cut up some of this onion and just set it aside. Great, the carrot, oh, take it. garlic. They give you a million and one garlics, I'm telling you. It's absolutely insane. We're over the amount of garlic. But yeah. Anyways, as I prep this, I'll just talk to you. So today, I don't know how long I have. They've gone to the in-laws house quickly, so we've kind of expanded our bubbles a little bit. The grandma is already in the bubble. She lives on the same property. She's literally just next door. And they've had an aunt or something who lives on her own, I think, who has been coming around for a game stay on a Sunday for a couple hours. But it has been at the nana's house, not here. Philip's gone and seen his mom a couple times. Stevie's there going to see her now. We've slowly, but his mom is fully vaccinated. The nana next door is fully vaccinated. I don't know if the aunt was fully vaccinated, but we basically have only been opening our bubbles to people who are vaccinated. Stevie has got one vaccination. She's just getting another. She was just waiting to get clearance, so she's got another one on October the 21st. She is pretty upset at the moment, which is why they've gone to see Philip's mom as well. Most likely their wedding is going to have to be rescheduled again for the second time, just because we don't know when we're coming out of these alert levels, so you can't really schedule it. And obviously it's not going to be by the 21st when they have rescheduled it. I'm not sure what's happening. They keep all that kind of stuff on the down low. I mean, she has been a little bit upset as of late, but, you know, we're all upset. This is doing a number on all of our mental health. That's one of the reasons I'm breaking my bubble and going to my sister-in-law's house. Not that these guys are making me feel anything, but I just really feel like I need to be around my family at the moment. And I know technically it's not my family, for those of you guys who like to say that. But I get great joy out of being an auntie. It's seriously one of the best guests I've ever had in my life. Priceless. No one can take it away from me, or at least I'm hoping no one can take it away from me. And I would never do anything to abuse that privilege. Really upset because I can't go see my godson for his birthday. That's this weekend. He's really excited. I think they're going to allow his birthday to go ahead because they're allowed 50 people, and I don't think there'll be any more than 50 people. So they'll have it, which is cool. It's a little sad for me not to go because he's 8, but he's autistic. And this is his first birthday that he's actually pretty excited about. So it is a shame to not be able to go there and see it. But I have actually gone and, hold on, I'm just going to change the song really quickly. I just had some swear words in it, so I wasn't sure whether or not it would even play on YouTube in the background or not. What was I saying? So it's just the first birthday he's really excited about. He does have his gift already from me. I've been really organized with gifts. Not so organized with Christmas, but organized pretty much with the gifts, so he's got his. So pretty much nothing I can do about it. Hopefully I'll see him at Christmas when I have some time off. Hate doing these on him. I mean, garlic. I feel like it's really sticky for some reason. I feel like I should turn on another light too. It's really dark in here because I've got the windows closed. But yeah, so I was really gutted about that because I was also supposed to go see some family, like some friends, I mean, while I was there. wasn't really looking forward to seeing my ex, but it is what it is. Especially at this time. This time of year is really hard for me. No idea if it's hard for him at all, because he probably doesn't even remember that it's right when pretty much I walked out. So it becomes difficult at this time of the year to see him as well. Especially with the stuff that's just happening with the baby. I have just discovered that he's actually started his own business for music. So that's really awesome to have him getting back into music, because that's what he did when I first met him. So I feel like he's coming back into his own and getting to know a little bit more about who he is. I'm not sure how things are going, trying to start a business and being through COVID, but whatever. I'm told, is quite happy and doing well. So working in retail was actually killing him. And that's that. So gutted about not being able to go see my godson, but it is what it is. Gosh, I've already been talking for 16 minutes. Hopefully you guys aren't too bored with all this. So I've decided to go to my sister-in-law's instead and go see my babies that aren't my babies. My niece is 14. Not as close with her, but hoping this could be one of those trips that might change this if I'm spending 4 or 5 days with her. She's just your hormonal teenager, but she's beautiful. She's beautiful, and she's a dancer, and she's love these kids. And then obviously, not obviously because you guys might not know, but the 18-year-old boy lives there as well, and we are actually quite close. Actually talked to him on the phone probably about 2 or 3 times. He was really cute. He was the one that called and remembered the first day of the first unsuccessful attempt. He's just amazing. He'll move here. They live about an hour away. Takes about 2.5 hours. They live about an hour and a half away, and it takes about 2.5 hours on public transport, which is how I will get to them on possibly Wednesday. Now, we're supposed to go tomorrow, because I was just waiting for these levels announcement, but a couple things has happened. They've got some stuff going on in their house right at the moment with someone who's staying with them, so she's just asked me to hold off just a day. Till I figure that out. So, I mean, that could change if I can't do anything. I mean, it's level 3, so it's quite hard to move people on. But they're supposed to be going away for a couple nights, and I am watching the kids and stuff, and they prefer this person not to be in their house, apparently. So, not exactly sure what is happening, but whatever. I will find out when I know. I need to know. And they will let me know whether or not it's a good idea for me to still come, which I'm hoping it is, because I really want to spend time with them. Lexi actually does some pottery and stuff, so I've asked her. She's a counselor, so that helps as well. I've asked her if I paid for some supplies, if I could do some, make myself a mug or a plate or something. I'm really keen at the moment to do some creative stuff. So that'd be quite cool to be able to do stuff like that with her. There's horseback riding, but well, there's a horse. I'm assuming you can ride it, but I don't know if I would feel comfortable riding it. We'll just see. Anyways, I'm really hoping I'm still going to be able to go. Got numerous messages from Eli. He's hoping I'm still going to be able to go. I don't know if he actually knows what's going on in his house. he's a teenager, so let's face it, he might just be in his room, not even paying attention to what's going on, but I don't know. It's enough of a situation that Lexi doesn't feel comfortable having him still in their house, so, yeah. And so yeah, I went for a walk again today. I've been trying to go on a walk, so I've now got the walk down to 50 minutes. Actually, I have a blister on my foot from doing it. But yeah, I've got to about 50 minutes and doing about 3.5K. So that's good. I didn't think I was going to get to do a walk today because of, because it was supposed to rain, but it decided not to rain till much later, so that was great. So I was able to get some work done. I'm still doing about, today I did about 2 hours of work, 2.5 hours of work. So that's good, because I put up some mat times, and a goodbye, because I'm transitioning to the other room very soon. I'm not exactly sure what's going to happen with that now, because, the maternity position, pretty much is going to start now. So I'm not exactly sure whether they're just going to wait. I just told the parents when my last day was. So whether or not they'll wait it out, or what. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter if we're still in COVID by that time anyways. Or level 3, which is a high chance we are, because she just had her baby. So healthy baby girl, delivered 37 weeks. She was going to work for another 2 weeks, but yeah, she's been at home, so it's been good. So we thought baby was going to come. Grate the carrots, finely chop the garlic. Just trying to see if this is going inside, or if this is for the, combine the radish, cucumber, and a gerber. So this must be going inside. Add the carrots and cooking. Oh yeah. Okay, so we'll do that. Sorry, I take ages to actually make any dinner because I don't do anything fast. I don't rush through stuff, so it takes me ages. But yeah, so yeah, so I'm not sure what's happening. I have a meeting tomorrow. We always have a meeting on Tuesdays. We didn't have one last week, so we've got one this week. And now they're trying to decide who's going in or what's happening. I am only working Wednesday because I don't normally work Monday, Tuesday. At the moment, because my team leader wants to work Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and then last week I went in for Thursday, Friday because she needs, she's doing sport care with her partner for the kids, for just for the schoolwork and stuff, and he struggles to do all 5 days and get his work done, so, yeah, so it's a little bit different, but, my headache's coming back. I've got a headache. Had a headache since I went on my walk, even though I've drank 2 liters of water and I've eaten, so I'm not sure. I did have a pack of noodles, so I'm wondering if I just had too much salt. So yeah, I've decided, and we've got asked to get a COVID test. So this will be my first COVID test. So I'm a little bit nervous about it because I have not had a COVID test. I have managed to not be around anyone who's had COVID. I have not been at any of the places of interest for COVID because, well, this is the first time I've actually gone out. I've gone out more in the last 3 weeks than I've gone out in any of the lockdowns. And I just keep to myself walking on the street. I don't go out very often at all in COVID. I am a little bit paranoid. I don't even like going to the grocery store. Because people are getting COVID from going to the grocery store. So, yeah, I would rather not. And I've not wanted to get a test. But for work, they're asking everybody to get a test so that they can let parents know that obviously those of us we're working, don't have COVID, and that we have our vaccinations. Vaccinations are not, I'll repeat that, vaccinations are not required to work in early childhood here. They could be, but they're not at the moment. But yeah, apparently parents are asking, and so the ministry was asking people to get checked, especially while we're in level 3. So I don't know if this is going to be a weekly thing or a fortnightly thing, which means every 2 weeks, bi-weekly, or what. Yeah, no idea. But anyways, I gotta get my first one tomorrow, so I'm not looking forward to that. But, I mean, if it means getting to go to work, then what am I gonna do about it? Because, you know, I need the 100% pay. Update on the housing issue. We missed a house that we really, really wanted. We've applied for 4 houses. Actually have not heard back from either of those 4 houses, which is super, super annoying at the moment. But it is what it is, and it's crazy times. I think they're still only allowed to have two groups of people through the house. So that's kind of annoying. So yeah, we'll have to apply for more houses, but probably once I get back from my vacation with my sister-in-law, if I can go on that vacation, which I'm really hoping I can. Otherwise, I'll be gutted. Like I said, there's no, like, I need to move out of the house. There's no, like, anything like that. So, you know, I'm not at chance of being homeless or anything. But yeah. Anyways, I think that's pretty much an update of what's happening, what's going on in my life at the moment. Oh, I added myself to a dating site. I paid $300 for a year prescription. So let's hope something comes up. It's a Christian dating site. Don't know if it's the best Christian dating site, but haven't really had anyone approach me on it yet. But, you know, it's only been like a day and a half. And right now I just want to get my mental health fixed. It's frustrating because I had it fixed for Sam, and then I stupidly went and tried to have it for Bailey. And I feel like it's gone. Back to like fright or flight and craziness again. I do still need to get my B vitamins. So that'll help as soon as I do that, but I haven't done it yet. Okay. I'm gonna start doing the mints and stuff, so I'm gonna end this video here. That took me ages because I've been talking to you this whole time. And it's almost half an hour. But like I said, I take ages to do this kind of cooking. Which is why I don't know if I would do this in my own house. And I don't know if I would do this when it's not COVID. Because seriously, who wants to come home after an hour and do something like this? But anyways, I'm going to sign off. I hope you enjoyed this, like, kind of sit-down video. I talked about a little bit more stuff. Yeah. And thanks for sitting here listening to me. Bye.